Hey, what is up, you guys? We are back to season 2, episode 15 of Changing Your Mind About South Park. This episode is a little bit different. We have hit another Halloween episode. This one is called Spooky Fish, and you will see why it's so spooky in a minute.
The following program is brought to you in Spooky Vision. All scenes will be accompanied by pictures of Barbara Streisand.
Yeah, so they're still not over Barbara Streisand. I love that they did a whole Halloween intro again. I don't know if it's the exact same one as they did last time or if they added new stuff, but either way, love that it's a Halloween intro.
Come on down South Park and meet some friends of mine.
Oh, it's like some 3D there. I also read that parts of this were inspired by the Mirror Mirror episode of Star Trek. Oh wow. Got ran over by the school bus. School today. He probably just ditched as a gaming. Got a beard.
Carmen, how come you weren't at school today? Did you eat too many pork rinds last night?
You guess.
No matter how I'm feeling, I can always count on you guys to lighten me up. What? I had to stay home today because my mother wasn't feeling well. She has the flu, and I wanted to take care of the house so she could stay in bed.
So he is a whole lot nicer than he normally is.
What the hell are you talking about, Cartman? Stop screwing around, dude. We're all gonna go meet at the store later to buy pumpkins to carve. Oh, then we can enter the carving contest. I'll run home and get money from mother.
I wasn't planning to have episodes line up like they did. I just randomly decided to start this series near Halloween when this is going up. Not super close. It's gonna be in September, but still.
Oh, Shelly, this one's for you. It's a television CD player surround sound home theater.
Wow!
Thank you, Aunt Flo!
Aunt Flo has come to visit.
Your very own fish. What do you say, Stanley?
I don't know.
I think he likes you.
It's spooky.
Oh, it's spooky fish. Spooky, I think it's funny that the aunt's name is Aunt Flo, because that's kind of a synonym for a period.
Aunt Flo?
Yeah,
Aunt
Flo.
She shows up, my mom turns into a total bitch.
My mom turns into a total biot.
Hey, Carmen, did you bring us money from your mom?
Yeah, right. You guys can kiss my black ass. You said you could get us money, Cartman. You guys are hella stupid.
Hella? I remember hella now. It's been a long time since I thought about hella. I've thought about hella, though, but not hella.
Because I'm hella cool, that's why.
I'm hella cool, that's why.
You guys are just hella jealous.
You guys are hella jealous. Oh my god. That takes me back.
Can you leave the light on, Dad?
Well, it has to be off, or your Aunt Flo will complain about wasting electricity.
Yep, I am a stickler about wasting electricity. If there's fucking lights on, there's ceiling fans on, I'm not about it. Spooky fish. Looking at you. Oh my goodness, where did it go? It is a fish, so... Oh, he's just under the kelp a little bit. Cover this guy up. I've did that before as a kid. Covered something up that looked like scary or whatever so I could sleep.
Who the hell could that be?
And their house is leaking because they're poor.
It's a heck of a storm out, yeah? Thought maybe you could use some provisions. Ain't much, but it should get you through the night. Take care, folks. I've got other houses to get to.
Nice Cartman is struffing out supplies.
Hey, where did the shirt go?
I ate the shirt. No, it's just on the floor.
It's not closer. I'm just seeing things.
Oh, now he's on your bed.
Mom! He's gonna kill me, Mom!
Is there a problem? Do you not like your goldfish?
No!
Sorry, I'm a bad aunt.
I'm a bad aunt.
Stanley loves his goldfish.
The fishbowl and the fish has reminded me of Fairly Odd Parents a little bit, too. Kill! Oh my goodness.
Stan, I'm in no mood for this. Not when your Aunt Flo is in town.
Not when your Aunt Flo is in town, Stan.
Stir up. Go to sleep, Stanley.
Oh, wow. The fish actually killed somebody.
I have had enough of- Oh, Stanley, what have you done, baby?
This
Mom,
scene?
I was just sleeping, and the next thing I knew- Shh, it's okay. It's okay.
Shh.
Such a good boy.
Such
Mommy's
a good
little
boy.
Angel.
Good boy.
Mommy's going to hide the body. Nobody's going to take my baby away. I've got such a handsome boy. Such a good boy.
So, one, Sharon is a writer. Two, she was so quick with that.
Sharon! Aunt Flo, look at you with your little shovel. Just
your little shovel.
It's going to be okay, Stanley.
Mom, you think I killed that guy? It was the fish. He says I'm next.
Get some sleep, baby. Mommy's taking care of everything.
But Mommy's taking care of everything.
Mama's gonna buy you a mockingbird. If that mockingbird don't sing, Mama's gonna bury it in the backyard.
It was a wild night there. We also never see Aunt Flo again. She's a character that we never hear from or see again, I don't think.
I've got such a handsome boy. Such a good boy.
Such a good boy.
Did you bring the pumpkin? Mm-hmm. Well, where is it?
Pumpkin. Oh yeah, I have my little tea with me today. Whoever heard of a squash-a-lantern?
Whoa, Stan, you don't look so good.
My fish has been killing people and Aunt Flo's to visit, so it's just been rough in my house, guys.
I have to get another knife. This one's hella dull.
Hella dull.
Oh, great. He's got that stupid beard on again. No, Kenny, you should cut with the blade facing away from you. There you go.
There you go.
You guys. Coming pumped are my best friends, to thick and thin. Best friends are we. I love you guys.
I love you guys. Oh, now the Barbara Streisand picture's changed.
What are you doing? What do you mean, what am I doing? I'm just standing here. Jesus, mellow out, you guys. Why the hell not? Because you're standing over there.
Ah.
I can't believe what I'm seeing. It's like I'm looking in a mirror.
Look, it's like split down the middle. I think that's making fun of like how in old movies it used to be a clear split shot when they used to have like twins, but it was like the same actor.
I've never seen any of those men, Officer Barbrady.
Never.
Mind if I look around the backyard, though? Missing people usually turn up hiding in someone's bushes. May I?
Usually. Oh, the treehouse is still there. Big cannon there.
Tennis, anyone?
Nobody's going to take my baby away from me.
Nobody. Pants are off. Oh. Today I've got I like his outfit.
Freaky french fries.
Chef?
Or haunted hash brown.
And monstrous milk.
Chef, we have problems. I have a goldfish that keeps killing people.
Well, don't worry, Stan. I'm sure it'll work out.
I'm sure it'll work out. And the split's still there whenever it shows them. That's funny. I love jokes like that.
And this son of a bitch is standing there. I'm sorry, I've caused so much trouble. I was just standing around, and Stan and Carl were being really mean as usual, and Kenny was just buying a new car.
This Codman is from an evil parallel universe where everything exists as his opposite.
But he doesn't even look that much like me. He's all fat instead.
Multiverse of Madness who?
My pet goldfish must be from the evil opposite universe too.
Hello, boys. I'm Stan's Aunt Flo.
Whoa, what's wrong with your head? Why are you shaking like that? Dude, that's not cool. She's got Parkinson's disease. Check it out, you guys. You don't even have to put a quarter in.
She's using her like one of those little quarter operated rocket ship things.
I got it from the pet store. I believe it was called the Indian Burial Ground Pet Store just outside of town.
Right, right. I think that's that Stephen King pet store. I've heard about that one before.
We gotta take the spooky fish back to that pet store. Who's we? You got a turd in your pocket? I'm going home. I'm hella hungry.
I'm hella hungry.
Just help me take it back. Come on. Did you find the address, Aunt
Flo? Oh my god.
No, not Aunt Flo.
That's two deaths now.
Good son.
What a good son I have. Sharon's a writer, I guess. And then now he's got Kenny. Oh no.
It's all taken care of, Stanley. Oh, I've got such a good boy. Such a handsome boy.
Hey, why is the basement door locked?
Gordon, I don't care. Jimmy Crack, Gordon, I don't care.
So there's been three deaths, and Officer Barbrady is tied up in their basement with no pants on. And Barbara Streisand is on the screen at all times. This is some of the scariest stuff I've ever seen. And there's a Terrence and Phillip Halloween episode.
No, Kenny, this is my pet. No, Kenny, this is my kitty. Who's my Mr. Kitty? My fluffy old pet.
And they're both just so different.
Don't get it, my kitty!
He can't stand that he's comforting them.
She's wondering if you've seen Kenny. You saw him, didn't you? You saw
him, my boy.
And he used to laugh and play. He was 8 years old, just like you, my Kenny was.
My Kenny was.
Tell me. Know something. Mrs. McCormick, I'm going to have to ask you to leave. You've been drinking. I'm a little drunk.
I'm a little drunk.
You'd be drunk too if you lost your boy.
You'd be drunk too if you lost your boy. She was drinking. She came over to the house looking for Kenny. She's disheveled in front of the kids, which is not great for the kids, and it's not like wholly appropriate, but it's also just shows she's just like distraught and tore up over it. It's real, you know?
Damn it!
What?
That's the 9th return I've had this week. Let me guess, it killed a bunch of people, right?
Yeah, dude.
Just like all the others, and it's another Barbra Streisand now. Oh yeah, these are all evil animals. They're cool looking though.
There was an Indian burial ground here before I bought it.
Just built your store on top of Indian burial ground?
Oh hell no! I dug up all the bodies, pissed on them, and then buried them again upside down.
Well, that'll do it.
We think that when you did that, you opened up a doorway to an evil parallel universe.
That certainly would explain a lot.
Like what?
That would explain a lot. He is the dumbest douche. He's ignoring every red flag and has no care for what he does at all.
Okay, boy, then.
There's a policeman being held prisoner in our basement.
Yes, hon. I had to restrain him so we wouldn't find the bodies in the backyard and take our baby away.
That's right.
Why'd you take his pants off?
Huh?
Sharon.
Sharon?
Why'd you take his pants off?
Oh, Randy, I just don't know what
She's
anymore.
Just making cookies.
What is it?
I can't believe that Aunt Flo is gone, that she won't be visiting me ever again.
No, so it's like, oh, like getting menopause, but she also has an episode later where they talk about menopause and she hasn't had it yet.
No,
Sharon Marsh, that is.
You can't sell people pets like this, but by golly, you're gonna take this fish back. And sir, can I make a suggestion? Move your store. And let these great people of the Wampanoag rest in peace.
You kick ass, evil Cartman. You know what I like best about you? You don't say hella like our Cartman does. I swear, if he says that one more time, I'm gonna kill him. He was here. Cartman,
oh, they're coming back
here
to get him. So, I know Cartman has the beards too, but on Kyle, it reminds me of Frylock from Aqua Teen Hunger Force. Oh, it's more Barbra Streisands. Oh my goodness. So are they trying to infer that Barbra Streisand is from the same evil parallel universe that nice Cartman and evil Kyle and Stan are? Because that's what I'm getting. Oh my god. To get all the evil animals on you at once.
Oh man, this movie is hella scary.
Hella.
Aha, Cartman. Nice costume, you guys. You spent about $1.50 on those.
We're here to take you back. I've got a better idea.
Why don't you two go fuck yourselves? What's wrong with you, Cartman? Let's see. I hate you guys.
I hate you guys.
Don't touch me.
What the hell's going on? Cartman never hits us.
You guys are from the evil parallel universe? Yes. You don't want me. You want that imposter, Cartman. And I'll show you.
And they start working together.
The winner is Wash-O-Lantern by Stan Marsh, Kyle Brosowski, and the evil Eric Cartman from a parallel universe.
She's dressed as a nun. That's fitting for her. Another Barbra Streisand.
Stan and Kyle have come to take me back to my world. I don't want to go back.
Don't worry, evil Cartman. You're staying with us.
Stab his hella ass back to your...
His hella ass.
Stop saying hella, Cartman.
Why don't you guys take our Cartman back? He's more like you anyway.
They want to trade.
Goodbye, you guys. It's been fun.
A bunch of people died this episode.
What now?
It's the evil pet!
The congregation gun! Get to the stage!
Here, it really was Stan's fish that killed those people.
Up yours, evil twin.
No!
We can't deal with you saying hella anymore, Cartman. You're going to the other universe.
Oh, they're fighting. He ripped his beard off.
Which one is the good Cartman?
I am.
Now, which one of you is the Cartman we can't stand?
He is.
Time is running out. You'll have to destroy us both.
What?
It's the only way you can be sure, for the good of the world.
Yes! Screw you guys!
How did you guys know? Our Cartman would never say anything like that.
You guys are hella stupid.
You guys are hella stupid.
You guys are hella stupid. You guys are hella lame. Hella, hella, hella. Damn it!
I'm sorry my wife held you captive, officer. She's been upset because her Aunt Flo isn't going to visit her anymore.
Well, I understand. I remember when my wife stopped getting her monthly visitor.
And I think later on he doesn't have a wife anymore in a later episode, so don't know if they got divorced or if that was another thing that was retconned. Alrighty, guys, that was all for Season 2, Episode 15, Spooky Fish. I appreciate you guys that watch and listen to me ramble. I hope you guys have a great rest of the day, and I will see you next time.